We've seen the nature of war really change over the last few years. And autonomous warfare, drones, and we think about that in terms of drones in the sky, and that's certainly a part of it, but drones in every sense, on land, on sea, undersea, is increasingly a part of the way in which warfare is now conducted. And when you look at the map, it's to your point really, as an island continent surrounded by big oceans, if there was a country which needed a long-range autonomous underwater capability, it's Australia.
Australia is building the Ghost Shark, an autonomous submarine designed for surveillance, reconnaissance, and strike missions, and we will have the first one operational in January 2026. They're highly classified, but are intended to act as further deterrence to China operating in the Indo-Pacific and to bolster our current undersea and surface fleet capabilities. But aren't we supposed to be getting nuclear-powered submarines? Why would we need these smaller subs if Australia will soon be operating some of the most powerful and impressive submarines ever built? And what will these subs be able to do? I'm Mel Pikos, and today we're taking a look at Australia's Ghost Shark, a history of submarines. Let's take a quick look at how submarines got to this point. The first submarines weren't much more than underwater barrels with hand cranks. In 1620, Dutch inventor Cornelius Drebbel built one that was propelled by oars and could submerge for a few minutes. He eventually built a model that could carry 16 passengers and travel underwater from Westminster to Greenwich and back. Various models were tested and built over the years, and by World War I, the Germans had developed the U-boats. In 1914, 10 German U-boats departed from Heligoland to strike British naval forces in the North Sea, launching what became the world's first submarine war patrol. In World War II, submarines hunted in packs, ambushed convoys, and became the unseen killers of the sea. Almost 3,000 Allied ships had been sunk by U-boats by the end of the war. The Imperial Japanese Navy also operated a range of subs, including Katon crewed torpedoes, midget submarines, medium range submarines, purpose-built supply submarines, and long-range fleet submarines. The Cold War pushed it even further. Oxygen extracted from seawater and nuclear reactors meant submarines could stay hidden for months and could be armed with missiles and nuclear weapons powerful enough to destroy cities. And today, submarines are stealth, intelligence, and deterrence rolled into one. But they're really expensive, slow to build, and still put sailors' lives on the line. That's where the Ghost Shark changes everything. What is the Ghost Shark? The Ghost Shark is a joint creation between Anduril Industries, an American defense tech company, and the Royal Australian Navy at a cost of $1.7 billion. It's what's known as an extra large autonomous undersea vehicle, or XLAUV. In plain English, it's a massive unmanned submarine designed to operate completely on its own. No crew, no periscope, no humans inside, just artificial intelligence and advanced sensors guiding it through the deep. The exact specifications of the submarine is classified and hasn't been announced.
We're going to be a little coy in terms of how we answer specific questions about what this can do, given the nature of what it does. But this is a capability which will be able to engage in intelligence, surveillance, reconnaissance, and strike. And one should read those words to the fullest extent. That is the capability that we have here.
But they are around 30 metres long and can carry different payloads depending on its mission. Everything from surveillance equipment and sonar arrays to potentially underwater weapons. It's built to be as invisible as possible and run silently, staying beneath the surface for long periods while gathering intelligence, tracking enemy vessels, or lying in wait as a strategic deterrent. And it's said to have a range of a long, long way.
There's a big coastline.
How far will it go? Yeah. Again, we're not putting a number out there. It goes a long way. And if you really press me on that, I'd say it goes a really, really long way.
Okay.
The race to dominate the underwater battle space is already well underway. The US Navy's Orca XLUUV, built by Boeing, is America's answer to autonomous subs, while China is investing heavily in AI-driven underwater drones to expand its reach across across the Pacific. The Ghost Shark is Australia's move to not just keep up, but to become a serious player in this new era of robotic undersea warfare. Anduril, the team behind the Shark. Anduril started in 2017, founded by Palmer Luckey, and I'm personally a huge fan of his, and a group of tech and defense veterans who wanted to bring Silicon Valley speed to military problems. Luckey first made his name in creating a consumer virtual reality company, Oculus, and then after he sold it to Facebook, he then turned his attention to defense tech, helping build Anduril into a fast-moving prime contractor focused on autonomy and rapid prototyping. And I love the name Anduril, Flame of the West, for the Lord of the Rings fans out there. That's Aragorn's sword. At the heart of Anduril's approach is the Lattice software stack, a command and control system that fuses sensor feeds, automates decision-making, and lets unmanned platforms operate as a coordinated network. Lattice ties together air, surface, and undersea systems so a fleet of drones can act like a single distributed sensor and strike system. Very clever technology. Anduril is working on a number of autonomous systems. On the undersea side, they have been developing a family of vehicles and payloads that feed directly into the Ghost Shark concept. The Dive LD and larger Dive XL are the civilian precursors to the Ghost Shark. Copperhead is a family of high-speed autonomous underwater vehicles designed to deliver intelligent on-demand capabilities from autonomous platforms for time-sensitive maritime missions. It can also be configured into Copperhead M, which effectively turns it into an autonomous torpedo, able to be deployed or launched from various host vehicles. And the Seabed Sentry is Anduril's autonomous undersea surveillance network designed to monitor and secure vast ocean areas, great for Australia's coastline. It consists of stationary or semi-mobile sensor nodes placed along the seafloor that can detect submarines, drones, and other underwater activity. These different projects all have the ability to work together, sharing information with each other, and potentially with other surface or air drones to create full pictures of the battle space. Crucially, the Ghost Shark program is not just a foreign design being adopted into Australian waters. Anduril is building partnerships, facilities, and supply chains locally. So the work grows Australian industrial capacity. That means Australian technicians, engineers, and factories will support, maintain, and eventually produce many of the systems, creating jobs and sovereign sustainment rather than simple import dependence. The total number of Ghost Shark subs being procured is said to be dozens, and the total cost of the fleet is $1.7 billion, with the first expected to be operational in January 2026. That is fast and quick, just what we need. The strategic impact. The Ghost Shark lands at a moment when the Indo-Pacific strategic picture is changing fast. Autonomy and persistent sensing are becoming as valuable as hull numbers and tonnage. For Australia, a fleet of extra large autonomous undersea vehicles would provide persistent presence across sea lanes and choke points that are otherwise costly for crewed vessels to patrol. That presence is not just about detecting threats. It's about shaping an adversary's behavior by making the maritime environment more transparent and more contested. One of the clearest uses for Ghost Shark is countering China's expanding undersea surveillance and sensor network. Beijing has invested heavily in seabed sensors, underwater communication nodes, and robotic systems to map and monitor vast areas of the ocean. Ghost Shark can be used to locate, shadow, and if necessary, neutralize elements of that network while remaining hard to attribute. In grey zone operations where states probe limits below the threshold of open war, an autonomous, hard to track platform gives Australia a discrete, scalable option to push back without escalating to overt conflict. And the Ghost Shark can act as a force multiplier. A small number of crewed ships and submarines can suddenly control far more ocean because of autonomous systems holding stations, feeding target data, and conducting long-duration surveillance. It also creates new operational concepts where surface ships and manned submarines work in deliberate teams with unmanned assets, combining endurance, stealth, and human judgment in a single fight package. And even with nuclear-powered submarines on the horizon, the Ghost Shark remains a crucial capability for Australia because it fills a completely different role. While nuclear subs offer unmatched range, endurance, and deterrence, they are expensive, few in number, and risky to deploy for low-level operations. The Ghost Shark, being autonomous and uncrewed, can operate in contested waters, conduct surveillance, or even deliver payloads without endangering sailors or revealing Australia's hand. It acts as a force multiplier, extending the reach of the Royal Australian Navy and providing a persistent, stealthy presence that complements rather than replaces crewed submarines. Finally, we can likely expect a change in how states respond to attacks on unmanned systems. Shooting down a piloted aircraft or sinking a crewed ship risks lives and therefore carries a much higher risk of escalation. Destroying an unmanned drone produces no immediate loss of life and is therefore easier for a state to do without triggering a large political or military response. There may be a surge in short, sharp engagements in which countries destroy each other's drones and autonomous platforms with limited reprisal. In practice, that means naval planners must prepare for a future where cheaper, replaceable systems are the norm and where deterrence itself must be rethought for a battle space full of expendable machines. But what do you think? Are drones the future of warfare? Should we be building a larger fleet of Ghost Sharks instead of spending $368 billion on nuclear subs? And how much autonomy should we be putting in systems carrying deadly weapons? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. That's it for today. I'm Mel Pikos, and we've been talking tactics.